All right, President Bush saying he will not play the role as pundit-in-chief, but he's breaking form in favor of Hillary Clinton. Take a look at some of the quotes from a new book coming out called Evangelical President, written by Bill Salmon. He says, quote, I do think she's a formidable candidate because she's got a national presence and this is becoming a national primary. The president adding that I think our candidate can beat her, but it's going to be a tough race. Talk about that this morning. Democratic strategist Bob Beckel, syndicated radio host Tammy Bruce. Good morning to both of you.
Hi, guys. Hi, Bob.
Hi, Tammy.
Hey, Tammy.
It's been a while.
So
hi,
the,
Bill.
Hi, Meg. So the president's making
Hi, Tammy.
He says that Hillary Clinton's, she's got this thing wrapped up. Tammy?
Well, let me tell you something. He's not just talking about Hillary there. He's obviously the prince of the obvious, and he's turning into Miss Cleo. I'm glad he's finally matched up with me when it comes to being able to determine exactly what it is the Democrats are doing. It's not difficult. I mean, obviously, with Rove gone, Cleo's got a little bit more influence, apparently, at the White House. This is not brain surgery. We know the president's obviously not a brain surgeon. The difference is that when it comes to who might win the Democratic primary, though, I have to say, with Ahmadinejad and the way he's being feted in New York, he might win it with the way the progressives are treating him.
He's on that ballot.
Winning New York would be obviously a very good thing.
Let me get to Bob on this. Is this a bit of a shocker other than the fact that the president sitting in office is making the prediction?
Well, first of all, I want to agree with Tammy that George Bush is not a brain surgeon. And I don't know who Cleo is, but let me put it this way. The preoccupation among Republicans with, and now the president, with Hillary Clinton, it tells me one thing, and that is that they are so afraid of this person. She, compared to these
afraid?
Republicans, oh, absolutely. Listen,
so?
These Republicans are rank amateurs, except for maybe John McCain compared to her. I think she's going to beat any one of them like a drum. And I think what they're trying to do is set up.
You think Giuliani's an amateur? You think Romney's an amateur compared to Hillary?
Absolutely. Not even close. Now, I think McCain's pretty close, but what is Rudy Giuliani? Ran a city, and he had one day.
Which is larger than many countries on the face of the planet. Miss Cleo, by the way, is a television psychic, and
the president wants
Hillary to be the candidate because they know that a good Republican can beat her.
Does anybody believe Rudy Giuliani would not, Bill, be running for president, was it for one day called 9/11?
As a producer talking about your Bob, say that again.
I'm sorry. Does anybody think that Giuliani would be a serious candidate if it hadn't been for 9/11? No.
That was one of the single most important days in our country's history.
Absolutely.
He made New York livable. Guys, he made New York livable. Crime has plummeted. Times Square became a normal place. New Yorkers were more happy. Taxes went down, essentially. It was a safer city.
That's fine. And I will tell you that Hillary Clinton debates Giuliani. He's going to run like a scalded dog.
Let me get to another thing that's in this book by Bill Salmon. A White House official, not named, talks about Obama, saying he's got the brains but relies too heavily on his easy charm. Then going on to say Obama has a laziness, an intellectual laziness. Is there credence to this, Bob?
No, I don't know where that comes from. I heard that, and if there's anything about him being intellectually, it's quite the opposite, I think. So I don't know where that's coming from, except that I do think that they also are worried about Obama as a candidate. So, I mean, those are two candidates, either Obama or Hillary Clinton, who's going to beat
Bounce that to Tammy real quick. Tammy, what's your thought on that?
My thought is Barack Obama is doing what he has been doing, which is working for the Hillary Clinton campaign, in my humble opinion. Why work any harder when you already know what the score is? And frankly, Michelle Obama seems to be the intellectual heavyweight there, but of course she is not running for anything. I think it's why should he work any harder when he doesn't have to, when he knows he will be withdrawing? If this race got interesting, it would only be because Al Gore got involved. That's when it would become a real race.
Book is out today by Bill Salmon. Thanks to both of you. Evangelical President is the title. Tammy, thanks. Bob, thanks.
My pleasure.
See
thanks,
you again.
Guys.
Okay.